Hello and welcome to Making Your First Script in Haas, Part 2. This is Karim again, I'm a community ambassador for HaasOnline, and in this video we will rebuild the bot that we made in Part 1, but in Script Editor. If you haven't seen the previous part, here's a short review of the strategy that we will be making. We'll be using two EMAs, a short EMA with period of 6 and a long EMA with period of 48. There's a common tactic in many trend-based strategies to buy when a short EMA crosses above the long EMA, as this signals an uptrend in the current time frame. Looking at the graph, it makes sense. We can catch these nice uptrends and downtrends after an EMA cross. So when the short EMA goes under the long EMA, we will sell, or go short, and vice versa for buying. However, the issue here is that it would lose money in these seesaw patterns, where the price is consolidating, not moving anywhere, and the long and short EMAs get very close to each other, so they will cross multiple times without any actual trend. Here you can see the price is barely moving, but the EMAs are crossing multiple times. Not even mentioning the losses from buying higher than selling, just the fact that we are paying the fees here for these trades is already adding up and hurting our ROI. When we are trading with a trend, we are losing capital due to false signals when there is no trend. So one way to alleviate this issue is to try and filter out these bad signals when the price is not going anywhere. We can see that usually this price movement occurs when the RSI is around the middle, not oversold or overbought. I'd say these seesaw patterns are happening probably between around 35 and 65 RSI. So to summarize, we will enter our position on the current up or down trend that is also conferred by RSI to be a strong move. For exits, we will just use the EMA crossing back. In the previous video, we had built this strategy into a trading bot in Visual Editor, which is sort of like Lego building blocks. Now we will do the same, but in Script Editor, which is more like traditional coding. First, let's again write out our rules so we can refer to them while we are making the strategy. We'll actually go ahead and copy the rules from our bot from the last video, then create a new Lua script and paste it here. There's no comment box here, but we can just type the rules and then select them and click Ctrl/. That will make it into a comment block. So if you remember, last time we just started by dropping the key comments or blocks. Well, here it's a bit different. Everything is more sequential, but we will also start with adding an RSI. As in Visual Editor comment search box, you can also just type whatever we think the comment is likely called, and then select it from the list of suggestions. So as we type RSI, then we have a bunch of comments popping in, but we need the simple RSI, so I will select TA.RSI. Once we added it, let's hover over the word to get some info. There's a description of what the comment does, what kind of inputs it needs to work, and what it outputs or what it returns. Then, at the bottom, we have parameters list. This is the same as the inputs on the left side of the comment blocks in the Visual script. In fact, they're exactly the same. We also need to give it a price source and the period. And here's the beauty of Script Editor. Instead of adding or connecting a block or even changing something to a field, I can just type the number right here in parentheses. So we have RSI, open parentheses, close prices, comma, 14. So our period is 14 and the price source is again close prices. Now you see that there are different colors here. This is to make it easier. So the green color is for the comments. They aren't considered code and the compiler doesn't read that. The RSI and close prices are blue and number 14 is faded bluish. So the intense blue text is the name of a comment or function. All functions must have parentheses at the end of the word. Even if we don't enter any parameters or inputs in the parentheses, we still must add the parentheses, otherwise the code won't realize that this is a function and will throw an error. So rule number one, add a parenthesis after every function, i.e. words that are blue. Alright, now we will be using close prices for two other EMAs as well, so it would make sense to give close prices some name like we did with session get in the last video. To give a name to something here, we just need to type a word that starts with the letter and then type equal sign. So let's call our close prices simply close. Close equals to close prices. Now we can use that in our RSI. Alright, Now, we should probably also give a name to our RSI, since we'll be using it a lot later. Let's call it simply RSI with small letters. Alright, let's also add a name EMA. So EMA6 equals to EMA, and inside the parentheses we'll type close for the first parameter and 6 for the period. The IntelliSense is also giving us hints what parameter we are currently entering. Alright, done. We'll do the same for EMA48. EMA48 equals to EMA, open parenthesis, close, comma, 48, close parenthesis. Nice part of comments in text editor is we can just break the rules into segments and translate each one line by line into code. Let's start at the top and go down. We'll translate the enter long rules into code first. Now, in visual editor, when we added is bigger than and is smaller than, there was also implied the word if. So if RSI was bigger than it would return true. Here we need to type out that if word. So we will type if RSI is greater than 65, then, and on the next line we can add the next condition. If crossover EMA 6, comma EMA 48, then we will do long. These types that I type are not required, but they are a nice way to separate different logic branches. For example, let's click save, and we can see that the compiler is telling that we have some error. Specifically, we didn't end our if structures. The full structure looks like this: if condition, then action end. So we must add the word end to each of these if structures. And here where this habit of indenting the logic branches comes in handy. We can easily see where we have an if that is not closed. Alright, done. Let's save it and try a quick backtest. The log doesn't show any errors and we even have our trait on the graph. So we have already made the enter long portion work. Now I think we should add the indicators to the graph. Usually this is done at the end of the script after all the calculations. So let's go to the bottom and type plot, open parentheses, and let IntelliSense tell us what parameters we need to enter. It asks for chart ID first. If you remember, chart 0 is the main price chart. That's where we plotted EMAs in the last video. So let's add 0 here, and then it needs a line name. Let's call it EMA short. Then it asks for the source values, i.e. what it will plot. Let's give it EMA6 here. When given a name of a variable here, we don't need to add anything, but when we are given some text, we must put the quotation marks around it to indicate that this is not some variable name, but an actual text. The last parameter is color. Let's make it orange. I just start typing orange. If I just press tab to a suggestion, then I don't have to worry about making a typo or capitalizing the keyword wrongly. Anyway, now we have it ready. So let's Ctrl S to save and Ctrl R to run a quick backtest. We can see the name of the line here at the top right, EMA short. Now we need to plot RSI and the second EMA. Since the comment is almost the same for them, let's copy paste this line twice. Then we just change the line names to EMA long and RSI. Then we set RSI to appear on the first chart instead of chart 0. Chart 0 is the main price chart and chart 1 is right below it. Let's also change the color of the long EMA. For example, let's set it to yellow. And of course, we also need to give it the proper data. So for RSI, we will specify RSI, our variable. And for EMA long, we'll specify EMA 48. While we are adding plots, let's also add lines 65 and 35 to the RSI chart. So we'll copy the RSI plot line and just change the colors and the source values. Instead of RSI, we can just enter an actual number, 65 and 35 in the other plot. Okay, our charts are looking good. So next we will add the trading logic to enter short. Under enter short rules comments, we can actually just copy paste what we have for enter long. Then we just need to change greater than 65 to less than 65 and change cross over into cross under. And of course, change the do long into do short. As usual, don't forget the parentheses after every function. Alright, we are really moving fast through this one. If you remember from the last video, we needed to add an implied rule to our exits. The rule was that for exit long, we had to have a long position. We used getPositionDirection function to check the position. We will do the same here. So under exit long, let's type if getPositionDirection parenthesis equals to position long, then if cross under EMA 6, EMA 48, then do exit position parenthesis and end. Let's copy paste this to the exit short part. Here we need to change position long into position short. Then change cross under to cross over. And that's it. We are done. As you can see that while visual editor may be more visual, for lack of a better word, and easier to understand, working in script editor is much faster. In the visual editor, you have all the comments showing all their inputs and outputs all the time, so you are less likely to make mistakes or forget to connect or give some parameter to something. Also, in visual editor, the order of commands doesn't matter. We could add plot first, but as long as we connected it to RSI, it would automatically rearrange the logic of the bot that the RSI command comes first. But here, we must follow a specific order. It's not done automatically. For example, if we add plot before RSI, then we will get an error since the compiler is reading code line by line from top to bottom. So when we try to plot RSI that is defined below, it doesn't understand what RSI is. Personally, I highly prefer script editor. I think it's more convenient to work with. But I can see how with visual editor it can be easier for a beginner to get to know algorithms and scripting. This is a rather simple strategy, definitely can be improved. For example, first thing coming to mind is we could try using RSI divergence to try and exit closer to the top or bottom of the price move, rather than waiting when it returns to the mean and EMA's cross back. We could also tune it even better by looking at the higher time frame, so we don't go long if there's a downtrend on a higher time frame, for example. We could also add a stop loss. Although, luckily for trend-based strategies, and especially this kind of short and long EMA cross strategies, stop loss is not really required. But maybe this is for the next video. Let's just add these ideas as a comment on top of the script for now. Let's do a quick recap of some things that would be good to remember from this video. First, to comment out line, select the line or lines and click Ctrl forward slash, which I believe is comment forward slash on the Mac. Next, always add parentheses to function names, even if you don't add parameters to them. Function names are blue. Next, put quotation marks around the actual text to clarify that it's not a variable name. Use if condition, then action, end to set conditions for some comments. I think this is pretty much it. If you like this video, please leave a like and maybe subscribe for more. Check out the HaasScript playlist on this channel, there are a lot of useful videos and guides. You can use this and other features for free. Just go to HaasOnline.com, click Products, TradeServer Cloud, create a free account, and register to get your Lite license. You will get one bot with which you can test and trade your strategies. If you have any questions, you can ask them below in the comment or head to official Haas Discord channel and someone will help you out there. The link is in the description. Happy trading!